Welcome to Superblocks. Today, we're going to recreate this furniture admin dashboard that an organization could use to track outgoing orders and monitor revenue. In 5 minutes, I'll show you how you can quickly build a powerful internal tool using Superblocks. Let's take a look at the Integrations tab to see the demo data sources that come with every Superblocks account. Every new Superblocks account comes with a sample Postgres database, Snowflake instance, and REST integration connecting to the Zendesk API. We'll use these in our furniture application. When we're done, you can come back and add your own integration to get started building your own internal tooling. To start building an application, head home and hit Create New. We'll name this Furniture Admin Dashboard. We'll start by adding a title to this page. Set the text to Furniture Admin Dashboard and make it a heading. Next, we'll create a new dropdown, change the label to Product, the component name to Products dropdown, and remove the example JSON data. We'll click Add a New API to create a new backend API using our Postgres integration, and we'll use it to populate our dropdown. I'll add a SQL query to get unique product names, hitting the Run button to execute the API. To finish, I'll rename our API GetProducts and our step to GetDistinctProducts. Since our dropdown references our new API, it'll render the response of the GetProducts API. Now, let's add a chart so we can see the monthly revenue filtered by whatever we've selected in our dropdown. I'll add a chart component, renaming our header to monthly revenue. I'll again remove the example JSON data, and I'll create a new API using Postgres. I'll add some SQL to fetch all of the orders, referencing the value of my dropdown for filtering. I'll click Run to execute the API. Since our chart is bound to the API response, the graph automatically updates to plot every order. I'll rename my API GetOrders and rename my step GetOrdersFiltered. Let's configure the chart properties. In the Properties panel, I'll remove the ID series from the Y-axis. I'll change the Y aggregation to Sum and change the granularity on the X-axis to Monthly. Finally, let's have the GetOrders API run every time the dropdown option changes. This will filter the monthly revenue chart to only show the revenue of the selected product. When the dropdown option is changed, an event called OnOptionChange is fired. We'll attach our GetOrders API as a trigger for that event. Lastly, to finish our application, we'll add a table. Add a table from the component panel. I'll change the table header to Orders. I'll replace the table data with our GetOrders API. We can reuse GetOrders since we're using the same order data. I'll change the format of our image column to render our images. I'll convert our date purchase column to a date with my preferred display date format, so it's now human readable. Lastly, I'll hide the user ID column to remove noise. Let's reorder the columns by dragging the price column before user email. Since the chart and the table component share the same API, the table will automatically be filtered using the products dropdown. I'll select a different product from the dropdown to see how things change. To finish, we'll click Preview to see our application as an end user will experience it. In preview mode, you're able to rapidly test your end user experience while you're developing your app, without needing to make changes to the production app that your users rely upon. Since I'm happy with this, I'll click Deploy. And then I'll click on View Application to use my deployed application. I'll add my coworkers to this application so they'll be able to collaborate with me. Congratulations! You just built your first internal app in Superblocks. Using Superblocks, you can quickly take your existing integrations and create the internal tools your team needs to be successful. In this 5-minute quick start, we've barely scratched the surface of what's possible with Superblocks. Taking advantage of our features, such as utilizing JavaScript and Python, state management, functions, timers, workflows, scheduled jobs, and more, you can quickly create the internal tools your team needs to be successful.